Hello and welcome to NewsClick. In recently concluded Tripura elections, the left front had to lose its power, and what followed was mass level of violence from BJP and IPFT. To discuss these issues and also the way forward for left forces in the country, we are joined by Manik Sarkar, former Chief Minister of Tripura and also Politburo member of the CPIM. Welcome to NewsClick, sir.
Thank you.
So let's start with, what was the reason behind the loss of left front? Because if you see all the social indicators, health, education, implementation of government schemes, Tripura government has been doing tremendous work over the last two decades.
At the outset, what I would like to tell, the alliance between BJP and IPFT was nothing but unholy one. Why we are saying so? BJP, now it is crystal clear to the people of our country that it is a thoroughly communal party. In the name of religion, caste, etc., etc., they are trying to divide the people, to divert their attention from the basic problems they are being faced and rule the country. And also, BJP is authoritarian. It is now being exposed day by day. What is going on in the parliament, everybody is watching. For last 6-7 days, I think almost all the opposition, they have been trying to raise one no confidence motion, but somehow or other, this plea or that plea, they are trying to prevent it. They are not in a position to face it. So this is not a democratic approach. And at the same time, they are implementing in a very vigorous manner, aggressive manner, the new liberal economic policy, which was actually started by none other than Congress. Of course, now they are very much aggressive in implementation of all these things. It means they are pro-rich. In one word, if you say pro-rich, that will not suffice. So, richest among the rich, they are trying to keep their interest. So to them, it is not unknown how IPFT, the full name is Indigenous People's Front of Tripura. It is a tribal outfit, how it has come to being. Actually, it was floated by what declared by the government that it is unlawful organization, that is NLFT, National Liberation Force of Tripura. They have actually floated this organization in the year 2000, just on the eve of Tripura Tribal Areas Autonomous District Council. They have been voicing this slogan, or you may call it demand, that there should be separate state for tribal in Tripura by curbing the present state of Tripura, bifurcating or dividing present state of Tripura. Tripura is a small state. Size was, it is 10,400 odd kilometers. Population is even less than 40 lakhs, surrounded by international border from three sides, that is mainly Bangladesh border. So this is nothing but to destroy the state of Tripura. So, knowing fully well, this BJP, they have aligned with them. So in this election, this IPFT they have been saying right from the beginning, only with those there will be political alliance who will support their demand of separate state for tribals. That means bifurcation or dismemberment of Tripura. And they said, we have no other demand. This is the only demand. So BJP has aligned with them, though openly they have not said they support the bifurcation or separate state for tribal in Tripura. But they have aligned with them. So this very slogan, separate state for tribal, that has created confusion among the tribals. And also I should say, after publication of all these results, they have been able to mislead sizable tribal electorate, including growing middle class among the tribals, white colored people among the tribals, youth and students, and of course the elderly people, a section of them has also been confused and swayed by this slogan, and they, according to their own way, try to make them understand or convince that if there is tribal state, then all jobs will go to the tribals, all promotional avenues in the government sector will be availed and enjoyed by the tribals, all contract towards will be enjoyed by the tribals, all land will go to the tribals. In that way, they try to confuse, and rather I should say convince them, though the left front government did not leave any stone unturned to take care of the tribals in Tripura according to the provision of the Constitution of India. The tribal areas, autonomous district council, very important thing. It was done by the left front government there in Tripura. The recognition of the tribal language that was given by the left front government of Tripura. Tribal land illegally transferred to the hands of the non-tribal, that was restored by the left front government of Tripura. Reservation for education, government jobs, and even in promotion. All these things have been done by the left front government in Tripura, and also development, basic infrastructure, road, electricity, drinking water, irrigation, schools, colleges, hospitals, market centers, all these things, because the left front government tried its level best to remove the difference between the rural areas and urban areas and tribal areas and non-tribal areas. And their economic condition was also improving in a very rapid manner. So despite all these things, we thought that perhaps because we tried our level best to make the people convinced that this is nothing but to disturb and destroy the state of Tripura, this cannot be implemented because it is a very small state, and curbing Tripura, creation of new state in this size and population, its complicity, this cannot be possible. But however people, this considerable section of tribal people, they have been misled. It is our preliminary assessment. So, because of that, earlier we used to get support from the majority tribal people in either in assembly election or in Tripura tribal areas, autonomous district council election or local self bodies election. But this time we have failed to get the support from the tribal masses. This is one, perhaps. And on the other hand, economic sector, the BJP, since they are in the center, so they have tried their level best to elude the people of Tripura. There are so many promises actually they have advanced. One job to each and every family. 9 lakh ration card holders are there in Tripura. In the state, number of government and quasi government, semi government employees, that number is actually more than 2 lakhs. Population, what I have already mentioned. So this is actually in saturation point. Until and unless non-government sector is developed, industry, trade, business, commerce, the generation of job opportunity is not that easy. And most importantly, this unemployment problem is a national burning problem. In isolation, no state, I am not talking of Tripura alone, even most advanced states of our country, either Maharashtra or Tamil Nadu, I am just mentioning, no state can solve this problem until and unless there is national policy to address this unemployment problem. And we have said to the unemployed youth of our state that 4 years back, this BJP government, the present Prime Minister, he promised that every year 2 crores new jobs will be created. Job will search for unemployed youth. Unemployed youth need not search for job. But what is the state of affair of our country? Instead of creation of new jobs, those who were in the jobs, they have been losing their jobs every week, every month. But Prime Minister, he addressed 4 meetings, a small state, the people who have attended his meetings, by and large the same people, they have been listening all this. No, Prime Minister is saying. And before that, the Finance Minister, Union Finance Minister, Mr. Jetley, he went there and he released their vision document, which they tantamounted as their election manifesto. There he mentioned all these things. Therefore, the unemployed youth, if not all, but large chunk and their family members, we think that they have been eluded. This is one. 7th pay commission, which was actually adopted by the central government 3 or 4 years back. They have not yet implemented in toto the recommendations what they have accepted. Partly they have implemented. We have approached, like other state governments, to the government of India that our kit is very, very small. So until and unless you help us financially, it is just not possible on our part to implement the recommendations what you have accepted at the center to the employees and workers of our state. But they categorically stated that we have nothing to do it. If you are in a position, you can implement. If you have no money, you don't go for. That was the general answer. Earlier government also, Congress government also used to answer like this. They have also answered the same thing. Despite all these things, we constituted one pay review committee, one-man committee, and they submitted this report that what steps can be taken in the line of 7th pay commission's recommendations. We have tried our level best to address this problem. We have implemented what the government of India has not actually implemented. In some areas, we have implemented those, like for public sector undertakings, for autonomous bodies, they have not actually taken any steps vis-a-vis 7th pay commission implementation, but we have done it. And some other areas, just main thing I have mentioned, we kept 600 crores in our budget, last year's budget, but we have spent more than 1300 crores to meet the requirement of the recommendation of the pay review committee. The one fitment formula is there, 2.57 at the center. We have actually done with 2.25. There is gap, 5.7 and 2.25. They allured the employees and teachers that no, this gap will be bridged. We shall do it. If you are voted, we shall take care of. That will be requiring every year more than 1,500 crores. But our position was not such. We cannot bluff the people. What we cannot do, we cannot commit. Then what's the difference between left and others? So we have categorically stated all these things to the teachers and employees. But we do not know how BJP state government will implement this. We have raised this point because some other states are there, even BJP rule states are there, they have not been yet able to implement 7th pay commission recommendation as it is accepted by the central government. We have raised all these points. Despite all these things, finance minister has released their vision document. He has categorically stated that yes, we will implement all these things. Prime minister in 4 meetings, he also stated the same things. Yes, if you are booted to power, we will implement this. We think that it has eluded this middle class gentry, particularly white colored people. Then another important aspect, that is REGA, MNREGA. You know, the whole country knows that performance of Tripura in MNREGA is splendid. We even went to generation of 94 mandates and clean, our slate is very, very clean. But in the last year, the financial year which has been concluded very recently, they cut it down from 80 to 46 days. But for 46 days, for generation of mandates, the money which was actually promised, they have not released that fund to us just to create economic blockade and problem for the state government, like other areas too. That is, but they have said if they are booted to power, they will ensure 100 mandates for Tripura. We do not know how they will do all these things. And at the same time, the rate of wages in Tripura, it varies from state to state. The calculation is done by the central government, RD department. Presently in Tripura, one REGA worker earn only 187 or 88 rupees. They have promised if they are voted, they will enhance it to 340 rupees. Then we were surprised what they are telling, how they will do all these things. There is a formula for Tripura, a special type of formula cannot be evolved. So all these things are actually hollow promises, but what could be done? A section of people might have been misled. Then there are social pensions. In Tripura, we have been implementing 33 social pensions, out of which only 3 pensions are actually being implemented both by center and state. Unitedly, center is giving only 200 rupees. During last 4 years, they have not increased, enhanced 1 rupee extra. They are giving only 200. But we, the state government, we are implementing 30 other social pensions. The on an average, the rate is 700 to 1000 rupees even. And for these three, central government pension, in this case also, central government is actually giving 200 rupees, we are adding 500 extra because we are giving 700, minimum 700 to these schemes which we have actually floated. So they should not be deprived of. In this situation, what they have said, if they are voted to power, they will immediately increase it to 2000 from 700 or 1000 to 2000. But during last 4 years, they have not increased even a rupee in their own schemes. A section might have been misled. So I just mentioned just 3-4 areas. So in that way, they try to elude people in financial sector, economic sector. So you see, through our activities, this expectation level of the people of our state, that is actually increasing. That is quite natural. But to meet their expectation, our capacity and capability was very, very limited. And considering the limitation, capability and ability, and also considering the attitude being taken by the central government run by BJP, we have not given any such commitment to the people through our election manifesto, which we cannot implement. Which are implementable, we have given those commitments. So here is the difference. So a section might have been misled because of all these things. So this is another area. Third, they have actually coined the slogan, Cholo Paltai. That means, let us change. Yes, 25 years, this left front government is there. So yes, they have been doing so many things, you are benefited. But let us change now. And if it is changed, then you may see the whether something better than that of left front government can be done by us or not. If it is not done, then you can again get chance to change it in the next assembly election. Particularly the new gentry who has taken birth after the installation of the left front government, we think that a section of them, and even the old people, elderly people, this slogan might have caught their mind also. Okay, 25 years they are doing, and they are doing well. Let us see, by bringing change one time, if we find that they are not doing better than that of the left front government, then again we shall get chance in the next assembly election. We can again bring back the left front government. I think in that way, they also appreciate like this, and people might have actually swallowed this sort of analysis. So these are the major factors, and above all, most importantly, that is the money power. What they have been spending for last 2.5 years, how much money they have spent, I think not a single leader of their own party cannot say. People are saying it is 700 crores, some people are saying 1000 crores, some people are saying it is even actually surpassed your yearly budget size, in that way they are saying. So they have purchased a large chunk of the print media, electronic media, and they have actually developed a modern method of utilizing their social media, etc., all these things. So yes, they have been working in this line for a long, long years, and also they have hard experiences from 2014 parliament election. All these things actually they have accumulated and tried to utilize in Tripura, and they have collected their experienced tried cadres, RSS, BJP cadres, different parts of the country. And for last 2.5 years, every month these or that union ministers, they were visiting the BJP leaders, their national leaders, their frontal organization leaders, they have been visiting. And while they are meeting with us, very good discussions, going out from their offices, sitting in their party offices, they were trying their level best to malign us and dishing out all wrong, false things just to create confusion among the minds of the common people. In all these things actually contributed in this election. This is your preliminary observation, and we shall have to undertake in-depth study, and it will take some time. It will take some time. I have just mentioned all these things according to our preliminary assessment.
So, as you pointed out these things, that how the funds flow was stopped, despite that the Tripura government has been known for implementation of NREGA schemes at a very large scale. So, how can the small states, when it comes to Northeast or other parts of the country, tackle such problems? Because the government at the center is always hostile towards the opposition parties in the states.
Because you see, we try to use every penny very carefully and cautiously. Very carefully and cautiously. Government was very, very transparent, and despite our limitation, we tried to increase our own state revenue also. Of course, that size is very, very small. So that was the only approach. That was the only approach, and we involved the people. We tried to convince them that we have our limitation in mobilization of resources. But if it is not properly put to use with your sincere effort, the benefits what we wanted to give to you, that will not be possible. So, from your end, you shall have to act in proper manner. And here, the local self-governments, they had played a very, very important role. Very, very important role. You see, ministers can dictate policies. The administration under the leadership of the bureaucrats, technocrats, they will only very mechanically try their level best to implement all these things. But until and unless you fail to encourage people, involve people, the people-oriented program, which we call pro-people program, this thing cannot be implemented. So that was our approach style of functioning. So in that way, we tried our level best to overcome all this, stumbling blocks.
So let's come to the situation right now. There have been news reports about how BJP-IPFT alliance has carried out mass level of violence in Tripura. Is it true, or what's actually happening on the ground?
Yeah, yeah, that is very, very true. After publication or announcement of the results, from the same evening on 3rd of March, the BJP, they have started terrorizing the whole state. The nature of attack, they have targeted our party offices at different levels. Ransacking, burning, looting, and at places trying to occupy. The offices of different mass and class organizations, and particularly our trade union organizations, and among them the transport workers organization in Tripura, Motor Shromik Union it is called. This is one of the very strong organizations working under the banner of CITU in Tripura. Their offices are targeted in a large way. And other mass organization, class organizations, offices. They are physically attacking our workers, supporters, men and women, and in some areas they are forcing our people to leave their place of residence, not everywhere, in some areas I am telling, where we have garnered good votes. That is what they have been doing. Also, they have started collecting money from the people. In Tripura, people are saying jizya kar. if you want to stay in this area, you have to pay us this money, this amount of money, that amount of money. They are trying to forcible collection. And also, the local self-government, both in urban and rural areas, the elected members, those who are with left front, forcing them to resign or shift towards them. That is what they are also trying to do. So all these things are going on, and also they are actually looting assets of the common people, like water bodies, fish is there, they are looting fish, and other things also, cows, bullocks, this, that, they are trying to actually loot all these things. All these things are going on. Some people sustain injuries, they have taken admission in the hospital, after getting treated, when they are trying to go back to their own place of residence, some of them are prevented to go back to their own residence, they have to take shelter in other areas. All these things are going on. Our party organ, that is Daily Deshar Kotha, this is the second largest circulated paper in the state. Its distribution is being prevented this way, that way. Reporters are under attack. People who are actually taking the paper to the doorstep of the common readers in some areas, they are also attacked physically. All these things are going on.
So how are the left forces in Tripura tackling this situation?
Tackling to it cannot be tackled by us, it should be tackled by the government. Na? What we are trying our level best, immediate after all these things, from 4th March, I must tell you, our people have started moving. Our leaders, our front-ranking workers, organizers, at the state level, district level, subdivisional level, block level, they have started moving around. They are going to the spots where these attacks are perpetrated. The people who have sustained injuries, physically attacked, we are trying our level best to stand by their side. Those who have taken admission in the hospitals for their treatment, we are trying our level best to help them. This is one part. And on the other hand, some people have been shifted also, because they were not allowed to stay in their place of residence or in their place of in their areas where they used to stay. So this is what our people are trying. And at the same time, in some areas at district level, subdivision level, our workers, they are organizing protest demonstrations, they are meeting the administration hierarchy, submitting memorandum, narrating specific the nature of attacks, mentioning name, place, areas, police stations, all these things are there. And in some areas, police is actually hesitating to record FIR also. So this is what also being drawn to the attention of the hierarchy. And also in the assembly, first session of the assembly is actually concluded on 28 March. In that assembly, we have drawn the attention of the government that if all these things are going on, you have committed to develop Tripura, you will take care of the interest of the common people. What left-hand government have done, you have committed that you will rather perform better than that of the left-hand government. If you want to do all these things, you shall have to maintain the atmosphere of work. The atmosphere of work means this precondition is peace, amity, tranquility, and democratic atmosphere. That is which is now shattered in a big way. So until and unless peace is brought back, amity is brought back, democracy, democratic atmosphere is brought back, how will we be able to do all these things? We have accepted this defeat and we have extended we have already mentioned publicly and also in the assembly that yes, if you undertake pro people program, if you are sincere, then you will get all sorts of support from us. If you see that what you are saying, but you are doing just opposite to that, which is not actually in the interest of the common people or for the prosperity of the state, then we will oppose all these things, but in a very constructive manner. So please try to bring back peace. We are a national political party. This sort of attack should be stopped. In this way, civil liberties is under attack. This is not proper. So until and unless democracy is actually ensured, prosperity cannot be done. So you are saying one thing, but what is going on there in the grassroots level, something quite different. So we want, of course, the new government, that this government will obviously see all these things. If they fail to act in proper manner, people are there, our people, they are not actually passing their days closing their eyes and ears. So people will act, people will act.
So this would be my last question. After the Tripura loss, the mainstream media built a narrative. People were saying that the left is dead. But we see a Kisan Long March happening where people are marching from Nashik to Mumbai. We see a movement growing up in Rajasthan. What's the way forward for the left forces in the country and in Tripura, seeing 2019 elections, which are just 1 year far from here?
About Tripura, I can tell you very humbly that left front has not actually developed from dream. It has not come from the sky. Through ceaseless mass and class struggle, this left front has developed. And left front in Tripura will further consolidate its position. Yes, a section of the left supporters, they have shifted. Otherwise, we would not lose. That is the fact. We shall try to win them over. And also, we are confident what is going on in the country, what they promised 2014, what is their performance. So from all these things, we are confident people will start realizing what is what. So if we maintain our link with the common masses, mobilize them in the field of struggle in a democratic manner, we will be able to garner support in a big way in the coming days. There is no other option. There is no other option. Because this government at the center, they are taking all this pro-rich approach. In this state, they cannot take different approach. Because other states where they are running the show, same approach they are taking. What steps they are taking in Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, or in Maharashtra, the people have been watching all these things. So in this situation, in Tripura, we can tell you, yes, that's why they are trying to maim us, that they cannot do. And people will not actually accept all these things, they will not tolerate all these things. They are just watching all these things. If they work, then yes, people will render their support, extend their support. If they fail to do this, then people will act. So in the national level, what you have asked, the coming 2019 parliament election, what I have been observing, the situation is being changed. New wind has started blowing. Not only Maharashtra Kishan March, before that, prior to that, I would like to mention this Rajasthan thing. Rajasthan thing perhaps also encouraged Maharashtra movement, and Maharashtra movement, all on a sudden, this march has not been organized. For last 3 years, ceaseless, sustained effort, one after another, they have actually done these things. So wonderful thing they have done. Peasantry in Madhya Pradesh, all this actually in BJP ruled states, you have been observing. On the other hand, the working class, 2015 second September strike, 2016 second September strike, they are staying strike before the parliament in Jantar Mantar, Tulak mobilization and demonstration. Apart from this, in states, these scheme workers, particularly mothers and sisters, thousands and lakhs, and they have been forcing the concerned state government to concede their demands. So, and also the banking sector employee, this insurance sector employee, and coal workers, steel workers, and other areas, the middle class gentry also, they are on the street. So, thereby, and the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, the people, the minorities, people, this because of their stand, the guruks are this, that. So, people are getting disillusioned, getting angry, they are coming on the street, they are trying to mobilize themselves. So, that's why I am telling that different wind has started blowing, so, and it may take shape, proper shape. In the 2019 election, what you have asked, the, what should be done? So, I think that our main point is this, that BJP government, it is anti-people, anti-poor, pro-rich. Our country has not seen this sort of government since independence. So, there is no other option but to oust it from the seat of power. How it will be possible? State to state, the secular, democratic minded people, forces, and those who are pro people, particularly those who are pro working class, working people, peasantry, agricultural workers, downtrodden people, those who are actually sensitive towards the problem being problem of the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other sections of people, all of them should be united. It may vary from state to state. So, if all of them are united, and then it is not impossible to isolate BJP and oust them from the power. So, I think this should be the approach and stand of different secular minded, democratic minded political parties and forces.
That's all the time we have for today, and thanks a lot for giving us your time.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching NewsClick.